Welcome back to the Palla Cazoria, and we are under the Oculus for the final time at Napoli 2019. Taekwondo so often thought of as an individual sport, and it is in many ways, but this, the team element, and it's mightily exciting. Men's team Karugi gold medal bout will be coming up first between the Islamic Republic of Iran and Egypt. Well, if you're new to team sparring, it's 15 gamjons only. Three valid techniques required before you go through and change person. And here come Egypt. The Islamic Republic of Iran, such a force in this tournament, but it's been the boys in blue who have been the true entertainers so far. The Iranians have been so calm under pressure, and they've delivered their results with a suaveness too. But it has been, these men have been the real entertainers. Led out by Abdulrahman Wael, who scored the golden point that got them through to the final. Also in this team, Salah Haidi, Ahmed Mohammed, and Omar Ghanem. For Iran, they include three of the individual gold medalists, Zarush Ahmadi, Mirosham Hosseini, and Amir Mohammed Bakshi. The fourth is Irfan Nazemi, who made the last 16 in the middleweight division. Despite the upsets of the Egyptian team against South Korea and Chinese Taipei, the Islamic Republic of Iran are the favourites. It is a position which Egypt will be very comfortable with. So in Egypt's technical camp, it includes their silver medalist in the men's under 80 kilogram division, Saif Issa. He's not competing in the four. He is the tall, towering figure behind the blue corner. And to start things off, it'll be Hosseini for Iran against Wael from Egypt. Hosseini in the semi-final, the fighter in the red, scored 9 points early on, setting Iran up for a great victory. And again, 3 points climbing over the head. He is their most devastating fighter. But Wael proved what a handful he can be in golden point, and he was the man selected. He was the person that delivered. Big shot there coming onto the head of Hosseini. It's not going to land, so the gamjon given against the Egyptian. Hosseini going upstairs again. Abdulrahman Wael, featherweight competitor. Hosseini in the same weight class, but in a class of his own, Hosseini here in Naples. Taking the advantage out to five. It's just a round of fighting, remember. In the first minute about to conclude. So the first change between the two, and Egypt and Islamic Republic of Iran changing. Bakshi is on for the Iranians. And there's Ahmed Mohammed on for Egypt in the number two. Pushing away to get a little bit of space. Bakshi, just a teenager, already making big moves in world taekwondo. What moves does he have here? Mohammed will be under orders to keep his team in touch. Next change on. Nazemi for Iran, and he goes straight upstairs. Another shot landing for Iran. This time it's the man, the only one who's not a gold medalist in the team. Egypt in need of points. Salah Hayri comes forward, has to then rock backwards to avoid that flash front foot. Big shot, trying to go upstairs, it didn't quite work. Hayri with the spinning attempt. Changes called from both teams, so back into it. It's Wael for Egypt in the blue. Put on the floor by Hosseini. 10 points the difference now. Iran looking very comfortable in this final. Tries to go up with the crescent kick. Another change for Egypt. You can see the nature of these Team Kodugi competitions. Fast and loose, and the pace suddenly changing. Lifted by the fighter coming in. Big crowds here today throughout the course of the preliminaries for the novelty of a Team Kodugi competition. Time for a bit of a clinch with Ahmed Mohamed. Egypt in need. It is the Iranian Bakshi who is just proving to be such a tricky customer. One of the things the Iranian fighters always bring is deadly focus to everything, and not an opportunity goes by they don't take, and Hosseini is doing it again. 15 points the gap. And even with 2 minutes to fight, that looks like a gold medal winning lead. Egypt need to summit Mount Vesuvius from here. Azemi calling for the punch. Adding to it that time. No point gap in Karugi, and that's another big shot. Going after the Egyptian and putting him out, adding points, adding big points. Erfan Nazemi standing up for his teammates, delivering such good shots to the head. Here is Zarush Ahmadi. Here's Omar Ghanem for Egypt. He's a tenacious fighter. He needs to become a spectacular fighter. 1 minute remaining. Iran with four gold medals in the taekwondo already. Heading, cruising for a fifth. No better man to be trying to see things out than Hosseini. Get the impression that he never wants this Universiade to end. He just cannot stop. Landing kicks to the head. He's been in brilliant form. Twice a Universiade champion in the individual side of things, and the Asian Games champion as well. Switches on. So new men, including Ahmed Mohamed for Egypt. And Mohamed is just manhandling his opponent, Bakshi. Furious end to proceedings in the men's Team Kodugi. Back comes Ghanem for Egypt. Big height difference between him and Nazemi. But he goes for the spinning back kick. Change comes in and straight away onto the front foot, catching his opponent by surprise. Does he grab the head? Steps out Nazemi. He had to avoid his head almost being taken off. The pace with which the Egyptian flew into the arena. And again, that's good defence right at the end and onto the floor for the Islamic Republic of Iran to win a fifth gold medal. Mirosham Hosseini delivering the final blow. Their talisman in the team competition, the number one. But they have been a cut above. Egypt with only their second medal in the taekwondo, their second medal of Napoli 2019 across the sports. It is a silver. And what an example of just how much fun Team Karugi can be. This Iranian squad have been solely focused on bringing home gold medals, and they've done that. Five here in the taekwondo, in the sparring. Nazemi, what a crucial role he played in just making the fights go above the points threshold from when Egypt can come back. Mirosham Hosseini, Zorush Amadi, Amir Mohamed Bakshi, and Erfan Nazemi. Congratulations. Now to the women's Team Karugi competition and Chinese Taipei against the Republic of Korea, the 2017 bronze medalists in the Universiade when it was held in Taipei. Now they want to return to their 2015 form and win another Team Karugi competition. Here is the four from the Republic of Korea. And here is the four from Chinese Taipei. So led out by Chen Yuchuang. The team includes Chuang Kuan Yu, Ma Ting Xia, and Su Po Ya, the gold medalist from the individual bantamweight division. The Republic of Korea, a formidable four. Kim Yu Jin, Yoon Do Hee, Ha Min Ah, and Jo Hee Kayum. Kim Yu Jin is the gold medalist from the featherweight division for the Republic of Korea. Yoon Do Hee, a silver medalist in the middleweight. Ha Min Ha, a silver in the bantamweight. And Ha Min Ah, pay attention to see if she fights against Su Po Ya at all, because those two faced each other in the final, with Su Po Ya from Chinese Taipei taking it in the bantamweight division. So we'll start with Su Po Ya for Chinese Taipei. And will be Kim Yu Jin for the Republic of Korea. So first points to Chinese Taipei. Su Po Ya, such a devastating front leg. She's lacking a lot of height on her opponents. And it is the Korean who then lands another two. She'll get another one here. Gamjon not given, so the score just remains at 2-1. Now it is the turn of Jo Hee Kyung for the Republic of Korea. Chinese Taipei going through the changes quickly, and it means that Republic of Korea are following them. This is now Chen Yuchuang for Taipei. And it's Ha Min Ah who just races off. Every fighter has to be used at least once. But you can leave any fighter you want on for as long as possible. Not just physically draining though, that mentally too. Kim Eugene. Eugene in the red. Supo Na in the blue. Poyar goes for a shot and lands it right onto the trunk of Kim. Chen is back on for Chinese Taipei, the gold medalist. Hit onto the back there. Chinese Taipei now with a 5-point advantage. Kim against Chen, and Chen is changed in. Coming off the front foot well is the Chinese Taipei fighter. Career pulling it back to within a point and levelling it. The Gamjon putting it square at 8-all. Only had just over a minute and a half. It's fast and furious in Team Karugi. So Chen against Kim. Big cheers from the South Korean corner behind the match. You can just see to the left-hand side of the screens. Supon Ya is brought in to try and calm things down and score more points for Chinese Taipei, which she does. Now it is Su against Ha, just for a second, but that was the final in the women's bantamweight. Being called off. Plenty of tactics in play in Team Karugi, with coaches trying to create a mismatch. Chen taken off for Chinese Taipei. Su back on. Su trying to plant the chop on Ha. Ha stays on and Chen comes on for Chinese Taipei. Still 2 points the difference. With Chinese Taipei ahead. Make that one. Only just over halfway through the fight. Plenty more of intrigue left in. Shot going and then the hook to the head. Chinese Taipei down the floor. Gamjon taken by Ma Xingxia. Now this is Yun. Chinese Taipei's lead now at 4. Trying to rattle off the shots to the body. Chuan Kuang Yu is representing Chinese Taipei and trying to just do a job on her Korean opponent. She does that. Yun has had to go off now. Joe is on. Chinese Taipei not needing to push things too much. They have the 5-point gap. It's been whittled down to just 2, though. Republic of Korea coming back well. And has Kim leveled things up? She hasn't landed it. Su for Chinese Taipei, the gold medalist in the bantamweight, being asked to put in a shift here. Tries to go for a shot to the body. Then she goes for the punch after breaking the distance, landing it too. Really strong work from Su. Two gets changed, so Chen and Kim, as they have done for a lot of this fight, matched up together. Another changing of the guard, 2 points the difference. approaching the final minute. Yoon Do-hee, the silver medalist in the middleweight, is on for the Republic of Korea, and big connection, but not the points, just swinging from too far away. Ma for Chinese Taipei keeps and preserves that lead. Republic of Korea hunting an eighth gold medal in the taekwondo, and Chinese Taipei just going for a second. We are all level, 17 apiece. So, Chen and Kim, the two most frequent athletes who have faced off in this fight. That's a nice back kick attempt. Trying to go for big points, 25 seconds remaining. Oh, this Team Karugi competition, this taekwondo competition at Napoli 2019, finishing in some style. Ma against Yoon. And Ma, for Chinese Taipei, lands 2 points. She's been kept fresh. More points looked for, not added. 5 seconds, 6 seconds remaining. Chinese Taipei with the advantage in the blue. And they're going to get a gamjong. Still 2, 1 second remaining. Can points be landed? They can't by the Republic of Korea. So Chinese Taipei take the gold medal. Only their second in taekwondo at Napoli 2019. What a final. It was so close all the way through. But Chinese Taipei had a little bit more. What a thriller. Yoon Do-hee there for the Republic of Korea. You can see just taking a lot of shots to the body. What a turn which Martin Xia did. So we're seeing on shot there in the blue. Chen Yu Chuang, Ma Ting Xia, Chuang Kuan Yu, and Su Po Ya. The awesome foursome who have got another gold medal for Chinese Taipei.